With a lot of the painterly effects I produce, I always seem to include a layer which has got a sketch effect on it. Now, I know you could go to Filter, Detect, Detect Edges, but I find that just a little bit too heavy with the lineage it uses. So I prefer to use my own sketch effect, but that can be quite involved. I think it's got somewhere in the region of 10-12 different steps to it. Then I thought, what about recording it as a macro? Now, a macro is brilliant, so anything that you use a lot of, you can record it as a macro. One click of a button can quickly and easily apply it. So let's see about producing a macro for the sketch effect. The macros can be found under View if you come down to Studio, and if you come halfway down, there it is, Macro. With the macro panel itself, on the left-hand side, we've got Start Recording, Stop Recording, Play. We've then got Reset, Add to Library. We can export macros and we can import them as well. Right, to our sketch effect. Now the first thing we need to do is desaturate the image. Well, really the first thing we need to do is to record it. So let's click on Start Recording. Notice the way the button turns a very pale color. Right, now let's head up to Layer. We're going to come down to New Adjustment Layer, coming across to HSL, Hue Saturation and Luminance. Now with this, always make sure you click on this one here. Now by doing that, if you've used any of them, it will then default back to the all colors, so that is important, so just click down. Saturation Shift, take that all the way to the left to minus 100. Now we're going to click to accept it. We now need to merge these layers together into one new layer. So let's head up to Layer. We're going to come down to Merge Visible. That's now going to create a new layer with our black and white image. But we need to invert this. Press, hold down, Command or Control. So press, hold down, Command or Control. Now press the letter I. There is our inverted black and white. We've now got a negative. With this, we're going to head to the blend mode. Changing it from normal, we're going to go down to color dodge. We've now got a blank white area. Okay, there's a few little traces of black showing. If you've got larger areas, don't worry about it, but head up to layer and go down to new live filter layer, blur, Gaussian blur. Now when this opens, let's just lift it up here. We're going to take the radius across, and as we start to take the radius over, you can see the sketch effect starting to come through. We're going to take it to around about that area. What have we got? We got 2.5 pixels. Let's click to accept it. The next thing we need to do is combine these layers into one new layer, as we did before. Layer, going down to Merge Visible, and when we click on it within a few seconds, there's our new layer. Where it says pixel, just double click, calling it what it is, which is sketch. Next, we're going to click on this layer here. Now when we click on it, watch what happens. We get the select layer, select layer one below current. In other words, we're on this layer. It's now selecting this one. It's just confirming it for the macro. So we're going to click select. Now press delete on the keyboard. That has removed it. We've now selected our adjustment layer for HSL, press delete again, heading over to our macro panel. You can see there it is, every single step we've done. We're going to click on stop recording. Right, let's click on the sketch layer, let's press delete. Every step, I think we've got 12 there. Okay, let's press play, and you can see how quick and easy was that to produce our sketch effect. Absolutely brilliant. Right, one thing, just clicking on it, pressing delete. This particular image was taken by my phone. And if we just have a look at the top, you can see there's the dimensions of it. It's only 9.98 megabytes in size, which is megapixels, which is pretty small. What if you've used a different camera with a much bigger file size? Can we adjust it? Well, we can. Coming down, where you see these little gear cogs, this is where you can edit the macro. Now where it says Gaussian blur, this is where we'll need to edit it. So if I click on this, you get a flyouts here with Gaussian blur. Notice a very grayed out little eye. If you click on that very grayed out little eye, it now brings up, please enter the playback name for radius. I'm going to call this G blur for Gaussian blur. Right, now the next time we play it, it's going to shoot through. It's now brought up this, let's lift it up so we can see what's going to happen. sketch effect, and this is where the fun starts, because as you start to move this over, just a small amount, just taking it there will do nicely. Notice the way it shoots up, and it doesn't look particularly good. So what you need to do is highlight it. Now we're on 2.5, let's put in 4. Now press enter on the keyboard, and just seeing how there, that looks better. So the best way to adjust it is simply highlight it. Let's try 5, press enter on the keyboard, and just seeing the difference that makes. There, that looks really good. Now click on apply, and the macro will continue to run, producing our sketch effect. So there it is, there's producing the macro. How about saving it? So if we head up to this icon here, we can now save it to our library. And if we click on it, or should I say add to our library, you can select the category you want to put it in. I've got default, I've got painterly. I'll put it into default. We're going to call it what it is, which is sketch effect. Right, it is now added to our library, and it's got 12 steps because it says so underneath. Right, with this, once again, don't forget, all you need to do now is just click on it. It's now going to run through, and there's our sketch effect using 2.5. If I just highlight it, let's put in 3.5. Enter or return. It's just going to adjust the sketch effect just a small amount there, and click on apply. Finishing running, job done. So there is the macro for our sketch effect. We can do a few more things. Let's just come over. If you right click, you can rename the macro, you can delete the macro, or you can edit the macro. If you click on edit macro, it takes you back over onto the macro panel. Here you can make any adjustments where you've got the little gear cogs. Don't forget, that's where you can do it. You can turn off, if you switch this off, the next time you play the macro, it won't delete this layer, but I'm going to leave that switched on. Right, don't forget, this little icon here is to reset it. You can also export it as well if you wanted to export the macro. The other thing you can do is you can click on it, you can drag, you can drop it into. So if you put it in your default category and you want to put it in whatever sort of other categories you've selected, you can click, you can drag, you can place it in as well. But I'm going to leave it here for the moment. So our macro, absolutely fantastic. We've done a sketch effect, but you can set it up for anything that you find you're doing a lot of. Just record it as a macro, and it'll speed your whole workflow up. Well, I hope you've enjoyed the video. Give it the thumbs up if you have. Don't forget to subscribe, plenty more videos to come. And if you click that little bell icon, you'll get a notification every time a new video is posted. But until the next time, it is Happy Imaging. And take care.